Hi everyone, this is Brendan here. Welcome to my next episode, Day 34 of my Let's Clash series. So I saw in the comments in the previous episode of episode 33 that some of you guys have stated that some of you have been finding a lot of high amount of loot in Silver League, in Bronze League. I don't doubt that because after the update, the recent update, a lot of you guys have been finding that. But then right now, I would think that the loot has been not too good over there because I've heard from a lot of my friends, especially those who are farming over there as a Town Hall 9 and a 10. They have been finding a lot of high loot in the first 2 or 3 days after the update. But as of now, I don't think the loot is as good as going back to Gold League or in fact to Crystal League. The reason for that is because a lot of people have dropped down to Silver League and to Bronze League to try to farm over there those dead Town Hall 9s and also Town Hall 10 bases. So I do not recommend for those who really want to farm really fast to go all the way down there. But of course, there are also bases whereby you are able to find those 800 or even 1 million over resources bases. But it's also possible to find those kind of bases in Gold League. The reason why I prefer to farm in higher league is because I'm able to find those kind of bases whereby it's easier to find those kind of gold mines or in fact those elixir pump rates. Because I did try using my other accounts to try to farm at Silver League. And those bases that I usually find are those kind of like those 400 or 500 thousand gold available bases with like 300 or 400,000 inside the storages. So it's like basically I either have to use a giants with healers or shredder. But for me, I prefer to barge because barging is my way of farming, especially when I enjoy barging than doing any other way of farming. Even so that I really enjoy barging to the extent whereby it makes me think of a certain angle, of certain way of attacking rather than just dropping all my giants and then just dropping my healers. And then of course, there's a certain way to use giants with healers. Basically, you have to take out the air defense as soon as possible before the air defense can take out your healers. So that's also another strategy to use, but I do not use that because I don't really fancy that strategy to use because it uses a lot of elixir, and the elixir now is really important because we could use the elixir to upgrade the walls. That's why I feel that barging is still the best because you will still have excess amount of elixir which you can actually use to upgrade your walls. So also take into consideration that I heard that the amount and the number of searches to take to find in Silver League or Bronze League, it takes quite a while to actually do the searches, and especially you won't be able to find this kind of rates that I'm currently showing you guys now, which are those kind of gold mine rates, just taking the gold mine and just running away with 240,000 gold stolen, not using all your troops. So I mean, I've not taken a long time spending my time over at Silver League and Bronze League, but I did take like around 1 hour or 2 hours to be farming over there with my sub accounts. So I did also do a rate as in how long did I take to actually farm a certain amount, and I found that the rate to actually farm over there isn't as fast as farming in the current league that I'm at. Of course, taking into consideration that the town hall that I'm also at also affects the amount of loot that I'm able to obtain. But I would say that the amount of loot over there is really high, as in Silver League and Bronze League, but I'm not able to find those kind of dead bases as frequent as finding it at Gold League and also maybe in Crystal League, low Crystal League. I've not been to like mid Crystal League or high Crystal League to farm because I've not reached there for my this account. But hopefully I'll be able to reach there soon. And also I've been pushing my way a little bit. So now as you can see, this is one of my methods of how I actually push my trophies up to just maintain my trophies as a town hall on the outside. So just taking out the town hall and of course just scoring the win. So going ahead with this next raid on this town hall 9 with the town hall on the outside. So now as you can see, the town hall is outside. Just going to snipe the town hall. So of course I'm just going to get the win and of course get the bonus. So just talking about bonus right now, I mean the bonus in Silver League is like super duper low. It's like just a few hundred. So the amount of bonus that you get from over there is like practically useless. Whereas if you're farming say at Crystal 3, the lowest Crystal League possible, which you will get 35,000 gold or elixir per win. I mean for those of you guys who are thinking that just 35,000, what's 35,000? But think into consideration that you do say around 6 or 7 attack wins in an hour. So say 6 times 35,000, that will give you roughly around 210,000 extra resources. But that's just farming at Crystal. What if you are farming at Master? Master, your loot bonus is way higher, which is at like 100,000. Compared to someone who's farming in Silver League, whereby the bonus loot is at 4,000 per attack wins. So just going ahead with this defensive replay that I like to show you guys, that's really interesting. So this guy is using some barbarians and archers to attack my base, trying to take out the elixir storages, of course. So going ahead now, as you can see, my clan castle has came out with some witches on the inside and also some wizards. So my tower is on the outside and the bottom. You guys gonna see as how useful the witches are for defense. So now the witches are just keep spawning and respawning the skeletons. The skeletons, they just come back to the battlefield, taking out his troops really quickly. Especially the archers, they won't be able to take out the witch as quickly as the witches be able to spawn the skeletons to protect the witches. Unless somehow he managed to drop his archers behind my witches, which right now he has done so, to take out the witches ready. So going ahead, one of my witch has gone down, another one has gone down too. So just left with the skeletons, have taken out a lot of his archers. So as you can see, that's how powerful the witches are. If you do not clear them and take them out immediately, you just have a lot of problem trying to take them out. So the way to take out witches is to try to bring them to like the corner, then after you deploy your troops in such a manner whereby the troops actually target the witches and not target the skeletons. So now going ahead to do my very own raids to try to do more loot, as now you can see this base is a dead base. So I'm not really too sure as how the loot in Silver League and Bronze League really is, because I just spent like only 1 or 2 hours there. But you guys can state in the comments below as how good over there, I mean the loot over there is. So it really depends on also the timing and also your luck as to whether you find those kind of crazy amount of loots. I mean, there are also times where you are able to find those kind of 1 million or in fact those almost 2 million amount of resources kind of bases. But those kind of bases are really rare, that's one. I mean, I've seen like some of the replays. I've also looked at and also spoken to some people who have been farming at Bronze League and Silver League to get a rough idea of how the loot is at Silver League and Bronze League. So this thing has already been around since like the update has just occurred like a few days ago. So some of you guys have also asked me to go down to Silver League and Bronze League to farm over there. But I don't think I'll be going there to farm, because I prefer to farm in Gold League, that's one. And of course, to get the amount of gold needed per day for me to do my upgrades is really enough for me. Unless I'm really wanting to focus on gold, which I'm going to do that on Town Hall 9. I might have a free builder free up so that I could actually use up all my resources to pump them into the walls. So we will see as how it go, whether I'm able to farm quick enough, maybe farming like around more than 15 or 18 million gold and elixir per day. And then I'll have a free builder definitely to try to upgrade my walls as quick as possible, because it doesn't make sense for me to overflow my resources. So having a free builder will be better. So I'll talk about that next time in my next few episodes, where I'll be talking about a little bit about overflowing of resources and also how to manage your builders in terms of upgrading your walls in the most optimum manner, and of course also upgrading your defenses in the most optimum manner. So yeah, going ahead to what I want to talk about also previously as to what we were talking about Bronze League and Silver League. I mean, there are also some people who also say that you guys have been finding a lot of crazy loots like at below 400 trophy range. I mean, for those lower town hall leagues. So it really depends on your town hall level, that's one, and also depends on what time you are also farming. But the most important thing about farming is whether you are satisfied with how much you are farming per day. I mean, do not take into consideration as to how much you are farming like say in 30 minutes or in 10 minutes, because some people are able to get like say 1 million loot in 10 minutes, because just due to his luck, due to that time spent that he played, maybe he was able to find two raids which had like a 500,000 amount of resources and he stole it all. And then he maybe the first raid he used like Goey Wipe, a very strong army combo. Whereas compared to someone who's farming at a higher league and then maybe he got like say 1 million in 1 hour. But I mean, you must take into consideration how much can you get per hour, or in fact in say in 2 hours or in 1 day. Like depends on what time you are also farming. I mean, some people, they are saying that they can get like 1 million in 10 minutes, but then in the next say 5 hours they only get like say 1 million or so. So I mean, it doesn't make sense for you to say that I get 1 million in 10 minutes, that means my rate is say 6 million per hour. You times that by 6. That doesn't make sense, because it just doesn't add up. It won't make sense because in the next 50 minutes you might not be able to find the same amount of loot as you found in that 10 minutes. So it's not safe to say that you actually get 6 million per hour, because there are also such cases whereby I've also done raids like a 1 million loot raid in just roughly 2 minutes. So it's not right for me to say that I get 30 million in an hour. But one thing I gotta say though, the loot has really improved after the matchmaking system has been updated, because you are not finding those kind of town hall levels which are like lower than you more often as compared to last time. So like right now, whenever I find a town hall 8 or town hall 9, the loot is pretty decent and I'll be able to attack it in really a quicker time, rather than to keep searching and searching and searching like last time, whereby it takes quite a while to search because I do keep finding those kind of town hall 6, 5 and also 7 bases to attack for my this town hall 8 to find. So yeah, it really has improved the loot. I'm not too sure about those who are farming in Silver League or Bronze League, because maybe some of you have also stated that there's something that whereby it's clouding over there, whereby you take quite a while to search spaces. So I'm not really too sure about that, but you guys can also hit me up in the comment section below. So yeah, I'll be farming in Gold League, especially when now the loot has really improved. I would think because of two reasons. One is because of the matchmaking that Supercell has changed it. The second reason will probably be because a lot of people have dropped to Silver League and also to Bronze League, whereby in Gold League and also in Crystal League, a lot of dead bases have appeared because not many people have been farming over there. So definitely I've been enjoying my time farming in Gold League, as the loot has really improved. As now you can see, I've been showing you guys a lot of high amount of resources loot. But you guys must also remember that this is taken in a 1 day playtime, not like 2 hours or 1 hour playtime. So it takes quite a while to find this kind of bases to actually attack. So yeah, going ahead back to my base, upgrading the walls and definitely trying to upgrade them. And of course, having 500,000 gold left to try to upgrade my elixir storage, as I'm trying to prepare for my next tower level, tower 9, so that I can use the elixir to upgrade the walls also, because from level 8 to level 9, I'll be able to use elixir to upgrade walls. So that's really awesome. So going ahead to upgrade my elixir storage to get more storage capacity. So now as you can see, I've done 110 level 8 walls currently already. So just left like around half of the amount right now. So going ahead back to my game center, I've gotten 165 friends. You guys have been really awesome adding me your game center. I really appreciate that. And of course, I do take quite a while to accept you guys, because game center sometimes lag. So I need time to actually accept you guys. So going ahead to check my profile, my attacks won have reached 402. And with my gold grab almost reaching to 150 million. So yeah, we are definitely close enough to reach to 200 million for the gold grab. And also the elixir escape, we are just like 24 million to completing the third star. So yeah, that's it for this update for you guys. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed it as much as I have. So yeah, with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my episode, and clash on.